Niemen Hao, Washoe Lam Brown Auckland Shijan, Nushiman Gentleman, Daja Hao. Same light, I want to acknowledge the Consulate General for China here tonight, Niu Jingbao. It's great to see you here, Mr. Niu. Can you put your hands together for the Chinese Consulate General is here also. Do you love the St. James? Oh, rubbish. Do you love the St. James? Yeah. Is it fabulous to be opening it up again? Yeah. Look, I'm just so delighted to be here. I want to, Steve, make some acknowledgements. And we need to do this with a little bit of explanation. First of all, the owners. I want to acknowledge the Chinese people here tonight. And I want to acknowledge the Lee family. Now, Jun's, who's standing over there, his mum and dad can't be here tonight because they are too humble. They are looking after his two children, he and his wife. They are the new owners. They have been in New Zealand for 25 years, and they wanted to buy the St. James and give it back to the people of Auckland as a true architectural treasure, because it's their way of thanking New Zealand for loving them and looking after them. So why don't we put our hands together for the Lee family? They've done a fabulous job here. Shishia. In that same, I want to acknowledge here the developers behind the project, and that's the Auckland Notable Properties Trust, and Steve Bealby here, again another very humble man. Steve, you and the trustees done a great job and actually working in beside the Lee family to deliver us back the St. James in pristine condition. And this job starts here tonight in particular. So can you please acknowledge Steve Bealby and the Notable Place, Auckland Notable Places Trust. Mike Given, who's working in beside him down there, you guys done a great job, Elemental. I want to acknowledge you and all the subbies. We didn't put our hands together for you properly. Can we please acknowledge Mike and all the those who are responsible for the building of this project? Can you please put your hands together for them, please? Woo-hoo. This building was opened in 1928. This wonderful theatre, an absolute architectural treasure in this city. And when we became a united city in 2010, one of the promises we made to each other was that we were going to work to try and save the St. James. It was a very clear message from the people of Auckland. We had lost His Majesty's and we were not going to lose the St. James to the people of Auckland for the future. And so we worked very closely with the retail sector and the former owner. And then we were lucky to find the Lee family and Steve and all of his team and Mike. Now I want to acknowledge, and Steve's done this, some of our council officers who did an outstanding job. I want to acknowledge Noel, Clive and Mike. Joseph, out of our team, can you please put your hands together for the council officers who did a fabulous job, please. Outstanding. In the same breath, I want to acknowledge my councillor colleagues, our Deputy Mayor, Councillor Penny Hulse, the local board, Gia Shale, the local councillor, Mike, and all the other councillors and local board members who have been a part of the support that we've given the family as they've gone through this process. So this particular part here, the foyer, is going to get formally opened on the 27th of April. And it's just fabulous to be able to link the Queen Street to Lawn Street as a new Auckland's latest laneway. It's going to be an outstanding open space with a new cafe right here, a 50-seater cafe, where we'll bring a little bit of music back into Auckland. On the 2nd of May, we're going to have the first opening concert, and that is called A Weird Night Out, and that's appropriate given the number of interesting bands who've played in this place over the years. So I'm really proud as the Mayor of Auckland to be able to stand here and beside Steve and Dame Trelease. He's going to have something special for us later, and celebrate the first public outing of this fabulous place, St. James Theatre, as it comes back to us. And therefore, it's my real pleasure. Are you ready, young man? It's my real pleasure. Have you all got a glass? We are going to toast the St. James Theatre. Are you ready? Okay, so Aucklanders, to the St. James Theatre. May she serve our communities for the next 500 years. The St. James. Most of the women here are wearing her gear anyhow. Ladies and gentlemen, Dame Trelease Cooper.
Thank you, Mayor Brown. Thank you, Steve Bilby. Welcome, everybody. Ni hao. And I would like to say thank you to John and his very beautiful wife, Nina. Thank you for hosting us tonight and for the wonderful job that you have done. I think it takes great bravery to take something of this size on, and I acknowledge your bravery and courage and your generosity to the people of Auckland. So thank you very much. This theatre means a lot to a lot of people in Auckland. We've all got fond memories of the rock concerts and the place where you can get up and dance at a rock concert. My last time here was a really big fashion show that I had kind of lights, camera, action, burning things and cannon fire. And, you know, I love St. James, so it's wonderful that it's coming back. Tonight, we're showing a little bit of the collection that's in store at Trelease Cooper just for your entertainment. So I won't keep you any longer. We'll get on with the show. It's Autumn, Winter, Trelease Cooper. Thank you very much. Oh, need to say, Mike and Claire, good job. Good job to all the subbies. I come from a building industry family, so I know what it's like. Well done. Thanks very much, Steve. An awesome evening. Thanks, everyone.
All I want to do is take you downtown, baby. Feelings is a no. Let me tell you how it goes. Curves the word, spins the verb. Loving it, curse, so freak what you heard. Rolling with the fatness, you never quite know what that path is. You got to pay to play, just for shorty bang bang to look your way. I like the way you work it, tough nuts, trump tight every day. You're blowing my mind, baby, in time. Maybe I can get you in my ride. I like the way you work.